Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the Hollywood Foreign Press Association, I'm truly honored to welcome you all to our Grants Dinner. This year marks the 75th anniversary of the Golden Globe Awards, an incredible milestone. We have come a very long way since the association's humble beginnings, when our show was put on by the determination and hard work of our senior members. So a big shout out to Aida, Judy, Noel, Mahfouz, George, Ali, Ray, Yoram, Jorge, who have been members since the 60s and 70s. We wouldn't be here without you, thank you. We have big plans for this milestone and will celebrate it throughout the year with special screenings, expert panel discussions, and more. To commemorate our diamond anniversary, this year's new logo displayed behind me. There. Signifies our never-ending commitment to recognize the best in film and television from around the world. The mission of our charitable trust is to foster education and creative expression in art and film. So we are thrilled to announce over $2.8 million in grants tonight. For a total of nearly $30 million over 25 years to organizations that will continue to further our mission and are dedicated to making a difference. We are very proud to have awarded more than 1,500 scholarships to educational institutions. As someone who received a scholarship myself, I understand the significance and importance of this part of our work, and I'm honored to be able to say that we have helped underrepresented students reach their dreams. In addition to our ongoing commitment to arts and entertainment-related organizations, the HFPA also supports a number of special initiatives. I'd like to take a moment to highlight one especially. For years, we have supported disaster relief and humanitarian organizations. At this year's Cannes Film Festival, we presented $500,000 to the International Rescue Committee, which responds to the world's worst crises. Let's take a look at that memorable week in Cannes.
I'm honored to present the IRC with a $500,000 check on behalf of the Hollywood Foreign Press.
Well, I feel like the work the IRC is doing is extraordinary, particularly today and everything going on in the geopolitical climate with so many refugees throughout the world needing a place to be and needing help.
This generous donation from the Hollywood Foreign Press Association will go a long way to supporting those individuals and families seeking safety on these shores.
I mean, it's amazing that an organization like the HFPA is giving so generously for this to this crisis. And I think that's something that's part of the responsibility of artists and the people who support artists to draw the world's attention.
You don't just see problems, you see solutions. You know that there's ways you can change that situation and you can transform it.
Before we have dinner, I would like to give you a little idea of what's to come, starting at 8 o'clock. As an association of journalists, we were all inspired by Meryl Streep's stirring speech at the Globes earlier this year. And that gave us an idea. To tell you about it, here is the star of Good Time, Robert Pattinson.
For years, the HFPA has not only supported film, theater, and education-related schools, programs, and charities, but has responded to a number of humanitarian crises throughout the world, including the aftermath of the typhoon in the Philippines, tsunami in Thailand, and Hurricane Sandy on America's East Coast. But rarely does an ongoing crisis hit home as much for the members of the HFPA, as is the case with an unfortunate new development that's taken root all over the world. The slow disintegration and disappearance of what Americans call the First Amendment right. Freedom of speech is under attack. In many countries, journalists have to fear incarceration or worse for reporting the truth. An alarming number of journalists are killed each year. Most of their murders are going unpunished, including in established democracies. The Committee to Protect Journalists seeks to redress this, works to influence policy, and ensures that justice prevails. Therefore, this year, the HFPA made a $200,000 donation to the Committee to Protect Journalists. Often called Journalism's Red Cross, which promotes press freedom and defends the rights of journalists around the world to report the news without fear of reprisal. I'm very honored to accept this grant on behalf of this worthwhile organization. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Robert. We'll be right back after dinner with the presentation of more grants, our MC, Chelsea Handler, and the biggest names in Hollywood.
Welcome back to the stage, Meher Tatna.
It is my honor to welcome our guest for tonight, comedian, talk show host, and all-round powerhouse, Chelsea Handler.
Hi, everybody. Thank you. Thank you for the applause in the back. Thank you, guys. Pause. It's a beautiful night. We should all be really happy we're not talking about the president. I would like to say good evening, and I want to say welcome to the Hollywood Foreign Press Association's 2017 Installation and Grants Dinner. Thank you, everyone. I feel passionately about taking this opportunity to leave politics out of the night and remain completely nonpartisan. I want us to have a good time and forget about the world we live in. So let's celebrate the three things Donald Trump hates the most. Foreigners. The press. And actually donating money to charity. I, like many other people, have had misconceptions about the HFPA. Shut up. I had many misconceptions about the HFPA. For one, it's not treatable. And for another, it's not just a group that votes for the Golden Globes. These members write for more than 200 publications around the world, covering both film and television. And that's a lot of fake news. And news about fake people. But today we're going to celebrate what I feel is the most inspiring thing that the association does, which is philanthropy. Yeah. Something we need to really, like, steadfastly hold on tight to. So over the next hour, I'm going to get you out of here by 9 o'clock. Everyone will be home by 9 o'clock. I know every time we come to this hotel, we're like, oh my God, when is this going to be over? It's going to be over by 9 o'clock. And then $2.5 million will be given out to more than 55 various charities. institutions, cultural programs, professional training, and Anthony Scaramucci's 401k. And please make sure to tip him when he brings your car around front. I want to welcome to the stage somebody who is a phenomenal example of a human being, the six-time Golden Globe winner and star of Noah Baumbach's, Noah Baumbach's upcoming The Meyerowitz Stories, a hero, an American hero for actors, for philanthropists, and just for generally good people, Dustin Hoffman. Yes, correct me, please.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yes, I want a man to correct me, please.
Noah?
Baumbach. Okay, they fucking missed the B, by the way. I know that name, and they missed it. Please throw, yes, they did. Did you see it?
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
See you upstairs, 1025, that's my room.
You gotta like her. She set the tone for the evening. All right, Hollywood Foreign Press. 1967, I met them. There were maybe 20 of them. And I was, what would they call it? The best newcomer, I think, of the year. And I went to the Coconut Grove, which isn't there anymore. And I remember seeing John Wayne, who was the MC, and Sally Kellerman, who was doing that TV show, what was it, the Flying Nun? And she flew in on a wire and landed in John Wayne's arms. Fast forward to tonight. All About Eve, All Quiet on the Western Front, all that jazz. What do these films have in common beside the word all? Each is a classic, but yet each needed to be rescued and restored by the Film Foundation, joining a long list of films that could otherwise have been lost forever to deterioration or neglect. And these are just the A's. They started out being nitrate, and they had a very limited lifespan. And it's odd that here we are celebrating an art form that's give or take 100 years old, and many of them, maybe one-third, I think, according to Mr. Scorsese, has been permanently lost. But since its inception back in 1990, when Martin Scorsese gathered a few of his colleagues, such as Stanley Kubrick, Woody Allen, Francis Ford Coppola, Steven Spielberg, its mission was set to preserve part of this country's cultural heritage. In these intervening 27 years, more than 600 films have now been preserved and restored for future generations to enjoy. For 20 of those years, the Hollywood Foreign Press has been one of the industry's strongest advocates in this undertaking, and with their financial support to date of more than $5 million, the HFPA has personally helped restore over 90 films. While last year, I'm not going to wait for applause the way Mr. Trump does. While last year, the HFPA helped fund the special nitrate projection room for the Egyptian Theater, this year their grant will be used to restore yet another classic film. Now, please Jesus, I got that old. Is it too late if I do a little thing? Please turn to the screens to hear what Marty Scorsese has to say about what the Film Foundation has in store.
A film isn't made of stone. It wasn't so long ago that nitrate films were melted down just to get the silver content back. Prints were recycled to make guitar picks and plastic heels for shoes. So when I hear the question, why preserve? have to really take good care of what's left. Everything from the acknowledged masterworks to industrial films, home movies, anthropological films, anything that could tell us who we are. We need to take pride in our cinema.
It is now my pleasure to introduce the award-winning director who will bring A Wrinkle in Time to theaters next spring, Ava DuVernay.
Hi, folks. How are you? Good evening. Hey. Did you know that in the 1920s and 30s, there were more than 300 films directed by women? Names like Dorothy Arzner, Louise Weber, and Ida Lupino appeared on the credits behind the camera. Amazing, right? How times have changed. Women in film, or rather lack thereof, has been a big point of discussion in these past few years. Thankfully, many efforts are being made to create balance and change. One such effort comes through the American Film Institute's Directing Workshop for Women, a tuition-free program that provides mentorship and hands-on training to increase the number of female directors in our industry. Please turn to the screens and watch their work.
The Directing Workshop for Women serves 8 female directors a year to make the professional leap into directing.
And let's roll sound, please. Mouth
beat. Action.
They have a boot camp intensive in the month of May, pre-production in June, and they shoot their films in July. We showcase them at the DGA in April. They are multiple award-winning films, and the filmmakers go on to have fabulous, interesting careers.
I love telling stories, and I've always told stories since I was little. And it's such a visual medium, and such a collaborative medium. 4% of directors are female. 2% of cinematographers are female. So clearly there is a discrepancy there, and I think that makes it difficult.
We have the issue across the United States that we lack for women in leaderships at all the highest levels of all the industries. When you see that NASA has 26% female astronauts and we have 6% female film directors, that's a horrifying statistic to address. And we have to address that and fix that, and I believe with these fabulous partnerships, we can. From the Directing Workshop for Women at AFI to the Hollywood Foreign Press, thank you. We count on these partnerships. We love our peer organizations in the industry, and together, we will change this.
This program, beautiful program, serves 75 women who attend monthly development courses, among many other initiatives. In addition to the previous year's participants, in that program also receive industry guidance at Pitch Fest, which is where they meet agents and managers and producers to pitch their projects. To date, almost 400 women have graduated from the program. Many have become Golden Globe, Emmy, and Oscar winners, including Cicely Tyson, Rhonda Haynes, Ellen Burstyn, Leslie Linka Glatter, my dear friend Nima Barnett, and the late, great Maya Angelou. I'm immensely proud to accept the Hollywood Foreign Press's grant on behalf of the American Film Institute Directing Workshop for Women. We are a small but mighty tribe. Onward for all of us. And to talk about the next few grants, here are the young stars of a very cool and acclaimed series, 13 Reasons Why, Catherine Langford and Dylan Minnette.
Hello. Well, this past year in 13 Reasons Why, Catherine and I got to attend Liberty High School, and needless to say, it was quite an interesting examination of the complicated life that teenagers go through.
My own experience of high school was in Perth, Australia, and Dylan, who has been working since he was 9, was homeschooled. So our experiences were a bit different than our fictitious characters, but still, we realized that no matter where you are or where you come from, education is so important.
Yeah. And it gives us great pleasure to announce a grant to the Los Angeles County High School for the Arts Foundation, specifically, yes, the Cinematic Arts Program. And more than 600 students, I'm gonna let you guys finish. I'm gonna let you guys, okay, cool, we're good. More than 600 students selected through competitive auditions and who reflect the diversity of this city are given academic classes in the morning and a conservatory-style arts program in the afternoon, which is taught by industry professionals.
Now, the Cinematic Arts Program affords these students a comprehensive introduction to the art and craft of film, and this grant supports teaching artists for film and screenwriting classes and for the year one Cinematic Arts Production class. An impressive fact, 96% of these youths go on to college or conservatories.
And now, please, I'm gonna let you guys finish again. So quick to cut you off, wow. And now, please take a look at two other organizations that do outstanding work in the field of pre-professional training, Global Girl Media and the Echo Park Film Center.
We're gonna get a shot in focus, if that's what we're going for.
They're shooting on 16 millimeter film, all of them for the first time. It's black and white and it's silent. They'll be hand processing the film. When we talk to the students at the end of the classes, they are really transformed by the act of making film on film. It's just magical to them.
To touch it, to feel it, to lick it, it's incredible to see that realization that this is where, you know, it all began.
Our courses are usually run during the summer. They're sort of immersive classes for 4 to 6 weeks, so it's just a taste. And then what we really want is for them to continue their career.
Being in London, Morocco, South Africa, Chicago, Oakland, and Los Angeles. With this grant, it's gonna allow us to do it, to get the resources, the technology, the camera equipment.
Thank you from Global Girl Media. Muchas gracias.
Please welcome a Golden Globe winner who can next be seen in The Last Tycoon, Matt Bomer, and the star of the soon-to-be-released Call Me By My Name, Armie Hammer.
I'm gonna pretend like I'm as tall as you and I need to move it up as well. Armie and I are pleased to be here tonight to highlight two of the many important grants being handed out for professional training and mentoring.
Oh yeah, that's me. For the past 2 years, I've been honored as an actor to have had two films premiere at the Sundance Film Festival, an incredible showcase for independent films, many of them made by up-and-coming and coming filmmakers. Sure.
Works.
Anyway, while the entertainment world shines its spotlight on Park City during those 10 days, the HFPA is allocating its grants to the Sundance Institute and the Sundance Feature Film Labs, which are dedicated to and developing and nurturing the next generation of leading-edge narrative feature filmmakers through its unique system of writing and directing labs all year round. What is significant is that these grants are earmarked specifically for foreign writers and directors who attend and tell their unique stories.
You're good up. Good job. As many of us know, women make up 51% of the world's population. Good for that. But that percentage goes down just a little bit when it comes to below-the-line opportunities in film and television. This is where Project Involve steps up. Overseen by Film Independent, this is a free 9-month mentorship, education, and career development program for 30 underrepresented filmmakers, primarily women and minorities. The grant also offers 12 paid internships to film students from HFPA-supported colleges and universities to work on various short films. In addition, the HFPA supports the following worthwhile programs. Take a look.
Cal State Summer School, Ghetto Film School, Inner City Arts, Inner City Filmmakers, LAUSD USC Media Arts and Engineering Magnet School, Los Angeles County High School for the Arts, The Music Center.
On behalf of these programs, we thank the HFPA, and Matt and I look forward to hopefully one day making one of your movies. Absolutely. Please give us jobs.
We're available. Thank you.
Okay, so we're all very impressed with all these worthwhile causes garnering attention, and we want to stay on track and make sure we open up our wallets a little bit more. There are two talented, recently Emmy-nominated actors of A Handmaid's Tale, Elizabeth Moss, and from This Is Us, which is a great big hit as well, Chrissy Metz.
So we're here to present the grants to three programs that inspire, support, and teach children art, photography, writing, and acting.
The first is an organization called Kids in the Spotlight. They give children in foster care a platform to heal and express themselves by telling their stories through film. Since it was founded in 2010, it has served over 350 foster youth in the LA County system, who have created more than 50 films that were screened at various festivals.
Kids also take the center stage at the Pablo Foundation, where they learn art and photography at their Shutterbug program that gives them something creative to do while they battle cancer. One lucky kid even gets to take photos on the Golden Globes red carpet every year. And the Lollipop Theater Network rolls out the red carpet for children during their hospital stays all over the country by putting on movie screenings for the little patients. So here's a look at two.
The mission of the Pop Love Shutterbugs program is to allow children living with cancer to develop their creative voice through the art of photography. And most of our kids keep shooting. We invite them to come back to our events as press photographers. The Hollywood Foreign Press Association has allowed students to come and shoot some of their red carpet events. I mean, these are amazing experiences that these kids are being able to participate in, and their talent is extraordinary.
We roll out a red carpet and we hand out movie tickets, and they take these tickets very, very seriously. And the kids get excited. You know, we want them to forget that they're in a hospital. A lot of the talent from the movies come in and visit the kids. So inspiration and hope and laughter that we get from movies, we get to give these kids that gift.
On behalf of all three of these worthwhile programs, we thank you.
And here's a lady who knows how to get away with murder, Miss Aja Naomi King, and the star of Detroit, Mr. Anthony Mackie.
Hello. Good evening. I grew up outside of Los Angeles, and my parents really wanted me to go to college and get a real job. I graduated from Yale with a master's degree in fine arts. Thank you. I'll take it. So I did the former. Not so sure about the latter.
Well, I can't compete with your master's degree, but like you, I actually studied my craft, first at the New Orleans Center for Creative Arts, in my hometown, and then the Juilliard School, which is better than Yale. As anybody, we
you
both know
me,
how important it is to receive an education and to get the chance to go to college, right?
Yes. And this year, the HFPA has added a grant for the Santa Monica College Film Production Program. Yes.
Yeah, give it up. Sandy Mo.
That's exactly what they call
it. No Sandy Moore alone.
Uh-huh.
Their goal is to prepare students for upper division study at a four-year college and to earn an Associate of Arts degree. The grant will go towards production costs for the class making the short film and support two sections, one in the fall and one next spring. The beneficiaries are 25 students in each class.
The grant for the Columbia University School of Arts Film Division helps to cover the tuition of students with 10 HFPA fellowship yearly, as well as production costs of their thesis film. Why is this important, you might ask? I'll tell you. Because Columbia's Masters of Arts program is one of the U.S. premier film schools, which has graduated more famous alums than many schools you might know. And it provides a chance to learn to...
I didn't say nothing.
These Yale problems. To learn to... candidates from 35 countries that make up one-third of the student body. How about this? Don't take it from Yale. Take a look.
All the crew that you see down there, we're all classmates. We're all second year students at Columbia. And what happens, it's usually we crew on each other's project and then everybody else sort of like helps each other out when they're filming their own project.
Columbia Film is in some ways very different than other film programs. We're about 50% international.
I love this crew because it's one of the most international crews I've been. I'm from Italy. Tine is from, the DP is from?
Norway.
Kachi is from, originally from Nigeria. The director is from Brazil. The AD is from Pakistan. Chuyen, the grip is from China.
The more times people of different cultures, different races, different religions get together in rooms working out what their project is going to be, that is world-changing. That's obviously world-changing.
One of the reasons international students get to stay and were able to afford staying here is because of the scholarship of the Hollywood Foreign Press Association. There's not much we can apply to, and without this support, it would have been hard for many of these people here, for me as much as them. So, thank you.
We thank the HFPA for their support of these schools and accept the grants on their behalf, as well as the following recipients: Cal State Fullerton, Cal State Long Beach, and the University of Southern California.
And we are honored to introduce our next presenter. He is a fellow Marvel hero and a Shakespearean stage actor. Please welcome to the stage Sir Patrick Stewart. You're looking good, baby.
Oh,
you look
thank
good.
You. Oh, from you, that is a compliment.
Hey, you know, I'm just going to watch you walk away, homie. Yeah.
Okay.
Let him take a picture.
No pressure.
None. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Well, unexpected. I am so delighted to be invited to accept and present this award, but also a little embarrassed and uncomfortable because I was completely unaware of the work that the Hollywood Foreign Press Association did in this regard. It is truly remarkable, and I commend it. When I was a boy growing up in the north of England, life was quite hard, and there was little to spare for socializing or for amusements. But there was a small, inexpensive local cinema. And all my pocket money went on movies, or pictures, as we called them. In that picture house, I saw On the Waterfront and Laurel and Hardy, Calamity Jane, and War of the Worlds. They were my entertainment, but more importantly, they were my education. as movies were for millions all over the world. But the world is different. My picture house is long gone. And around the world, millions of lives are destroyed and uprooted, fleeing their homelands and leaving behind safety, security, and all the pleasures that they were used to, and only to end up in refugee camps. Now, the Hollywood Foreign Press Association has for years supported one organization that aims to make life in many of those camps bearable. In 1999, independent filmmakers started Film Aid as a response to the refugee crisis in Kosovo. And since then, Film Aid has been working in 11 countries, from Afghanistan to Tanzania, from Jordan to Colombia. Their staff of aid workers know that art can bring healing, that one can find hope through creating. And so they not only screen movies in the camps, but they have introduced workshops, classes that enable refugees to learn how to pick up a camera, how to write, to direct, produce, edit, and have their own work shown at Film Aid's annual film festival that is seen by more than 500,000 people in Kenya alone. And it is with very great pride and deep gratitude that I accept the HFPA grant on behalf of Film Aid. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to introduce a performer who can even wrap Wolverine around her finger with an amazing voice. If you don't know her yet, you're in for a real treat. Please welcome one of the stars of the upcoming Greatest Showman, Keala Settle.
Children are future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody's searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my need. A lonely place to be. And so I learned to depend on me. I decided me.
No, keep it going for her. That was amazing. I want to remind everyone tonight, I mean, these amazing women are coming out to perform, and it's a wonderful time for women in entertainment, actually, ironically. I think there's so many wonderful people here tonight, including Christy Metz and including Elizabeth Moss from Handmaid's Tale. People are doing really wonderful things in entertainment, and we owe that to women and to all the men in this room for supporting women. So thank you very much. Fun fact, the next person can't sing, but it doesn't really matter because she's the president of the HFPA. Please welcome back Meher Tatna.
I would like to acknowledge the hard work of our trustees, our grants officer, Sandra Cuneo. And our board members, Vice President Anka Hoffman, Treasurer Ali Saar, Executive Secretary Janet Napales, and our board members, Chairman Lorenzo Soria, Luca Celada, Helen Herna, Yoram Kahana, Ruben Napales, and Kirpi Wimonen Ballesteros. And our staff, COO and Legal Counsel Gregory Gettner, Zoya Malinskaya, Lisa Tyler, David Castro, Jason Little, and our newest addition, Carrie DiNardo, who will replace our beloved Chantal Dinage. Chantal has been the backbone of our association. She's going to retire after the Globes. She's worked tirelessly for us as long as we can remember. And nobody will have a more well-deserved retirement. Chantal, thank you for putting up with us for 23 years. Actors talk about their objective to create new and different characters, but our next presenter, since making The Destroyer in 1941, has created more than 360. It is obvious to say that without his talent and imagination, our biggest movies today would not exist. Joining him is the star of one of those movies, who will showcase the first black superhero, Black Panther, and the soon-to-be-released Marshall. Please welcome Chadwick Boseman and Stan Lee.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to take this one. Thank you. Are these our cue cards?
I think that's somebody else's.
Oh, yeah. I couldn't read them anyway. I got news for you.
Dustin
I'm
Hoffman,
half deaf, half blind, so forgive whatever I say. I think there's an audience there.
Yeah.
I think I hear something, but Chad is going to be my crutch.
No.
So be kind to him. I need the guy.
You don't need a crutch. In the film Captain America: Civil War,
I got to introduce the character of Black Panther and become part of the greater Marvel Universe.
Terrific.
That's a career changer.
I created this man.
I was about to say that, see? And none of that would have happened without the creative genius of this man standing beside me, Mr. Stan Lee.
We all know that.
Yeah, keep it going, keep it going, keep it going, keep it going, keep it going. My screen persona was certainly helped by the incredible animated artists who worked on Captain America Civil War and now Black Panther. And where do many of them learn their craft?
At the California School of Art.
That's right.
And don't forget it.
This grant from the HFPA will support various fellowships for up to 10 top-ranked undergraduate students that will help them study dramatic narrative, experimental live action, and something quite dear to me, character-based animation. Over the years, more than 140 careers have been shaped by this grant. Please take a look at how HFPA grants are supporting some young animators at CalArts.
I'm in character animation. I'm a third year here, and I'm specializing in story.
Animation is a series of drawings flipped at a quick pace that make movement. Animation is storytelling.
As an artist, I grew so much. I failed so many times. From coming to CalArts, I met so many amazing artists who really inspired me and said, failure is how you can grow.
There is something very unique, what you breathe at CalArts, the sense of everybody's an artist and you're all in this together.
The grants that we get here help us so much to get programs that we need, new computers when the computers get outdated, like we just got a ton of new computers and character animation to really help us. We can color our films and we can ink our films to make them as polished as anything else through the use of computers and the programs that we have here at CalArts.
To HFPA, from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you so much for supporting CalArts.
Thank you for the scholarship you gave me that made it possible for me to finish my studies here at CalArts.
Mahalo.
Gracias.
They gave those guys more screen time than us. But I want to tell you, the idea of CalArts, the idea of all those people learning something so vitally important, so exciting, something that'll be a career for them all their life, I love it. And the best thing about it, I'm going to get every one of them to leave a space for a little cameo for me in whatever they do. Will you do that?
Yes. Thank you.
That's it. I got a lot more I could say. I have to go. Oh, well. See you next time.
No.
What? That was my exit. Don't ruin it.
That was. Y'all got to keep this thing rolling. Yeah. We're not on the script here. And now please welcome a man who actually made going to the hospital funny in The Big Sick, and the Emmy nominee who will soon be seen in A Bad Mom's Christmas. Kumail Nanjiani and Katherine Hahn.
Oh, great. Terrific. See ya.
Hi.
I wanted to try to hide my ripped frock, but I guess not.
Don't mention it.
All right.
That's the best way to hide it.
It's a part of the dress.
It's ripped, and she's been on about it for a while. Before we get started, I must tell you, Catherine,
yeah?
I love Dick.
Oh. Thank you, Kumail. That's very sweet. That's really sweet. Though I have found that in this town, a lot of people love Dick. Or are dicks.
Hey, our projects rhyme. I love Dick, The Big Sick. Maybe we collaborate on something. I love The Big Sick Dick.
Oh.
Nope, terrible idea.
Yeah, you know what? I think we've got enough Big Sick Dicks swinging around already for my taste, Kumail. You know what I'm saying?
Totally. But we're not here to set up projects.
Or are we?
This is gonna be a fuck of a segue. We're here to talk about the Zimmer Children's Museum and their neighborhood-based film program. You know, sometimes you think this is going to be okay, and then you're up here in front of hundreds of people going, this is the worst segue of all time. A bunch
Very
of penis
natural.
Jokes, and then here's
children.
Something. Okay. This unique grant will provide pre-professional education and training for those youths who are interested in filmmaking in some of LA's most underserved communities.
So we are honored to announce a new grant awarded to the Los Angeles LGBT Center for their Outset Young Filmmakers Project. This empowerment program provides at-risk LGBTQ youth ages 16 to 24 with a hands-on experience in a fully supported filmmaking environment. This includes mentorship with industry professionals who will steal their ideas.
She's joking.
No, I'm not kidding.
She's not kidding.
I'm not kidding.
It'll happen.
These youths, many of whom have no other place to turn to than the center, will write, direct, and produce their own six-minute films that focus on issues relevant to the LGBTQ community.
Now, this project is exciting because we need stories told from all different points of view. That is the only way we can use art to affect actual change. So please join us in watching this short video about some impressive new LGBTQ filmmakers.
Los Angeles LGBT Center is the largest LGBT center in the world. We have everything from health services, mental health, youth services, services for senior, cultural arts, really you name it. We decided that we wanted to start a filmmaking program because so many of the youth that we work with here in Los Angeles, that's their dream, right? Their dream is to be in the entertainment industry. So we're partnering with OutFest, and OutFest is an LGBTQ film festival that happens in Los Angeles here every single year. But they actually have a broader vision of wanting to continue the legacy of LGBTQ stories being told. They are all about finding the next generation of filmmakers and storytellers and equipping them and inspiring them.
So I've seen kids who literally come into our program with no skills, but a passion and some sort of narrative that they want to share with the world. And they literally, as long as they showed the commitment and as long as they showed the drive, they have told some superb stories.
They helped me create a defined goal to get to where I wanted to go, and also gave me the support I needed to be able to pursue that.
This program celebrated 5 years in 2016, and we were not able to run this program in 2017 because of budget cuts. So when Hollywood Foreign Press came and said that they would make a grant towards this program, we were able to relaunch it. So we're relaunching Outset after a year hiatus because of this money.
Wow, that's beautiful. That looks awesome. To talk about the next grant recipient is one of the stars of GLOW and the upcoming feature, The Papers. And joining her is one of TV's most entertaining lawyers. Please welcome Alison Brie and Better Call Saul's Bob Odenkirk.
That was too much goofing around.
Yeah.
Come on now, some respect.
Get it together.
I am also in the papers, please.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not
Get
just
right.
you.
Both of us in the papers together. Out in December. Good evening,
I know, because I read my IMDb page every 5 minutes.
I just keep refreshing it.
Good
God,
evening, Alice.
Too much. It was too long.
Good evening.
Good evening, Bob.
Yes. You know, we have something in common. I also started my career as a wrestler.
What? Yeah. I'm shocked. Did you learn
says,
how to
it says you're shocked.
What? Did you learn how to body slam?
No, I wrestled with my conscience.
Oh. Oh.
And I lost every time. I was raised Catholic, so it was not a fair fight. Okay.
I'm really sorry to hear that.
It was terrible.
This is not the time.
But that's just banter. Let's read the thing.
The HFPA is giving a new grant to a very worthy and often misunderstood group of people, the Veterans of America.
Veterans. And Film and Television is an organization right here in Los Angeles that was founded only 5 years ago. The organization's over 3,000 members have a chance to learn the ins and outs of the industry, and that includes veterans from World War II right up until current military engagement. In fact, over half of the membership is between 25 and 46 years young.
Some of them have already gotten a career out of the classes and workshops. They've worked on big TV networks and made impressive short films and even features. Take a look.
Here we go.
Brian Hansen, specialist in 3rd Ranger Battalion, 75th Ranger Regiment. That's the United States Army.
I'm Barbara Otan. I was a captain in the United States Army. I was an engineer officer, and I served in the 65th Engineer Battalion.
I will always place the mission first.
When I was younger, I always wanted to be a writer.
I had gone to film school, and I was already bartending, but I didn't feel complete in my own personal experience, so I enlisted.
I also wanted to experience life and have an adventure, and so for me, that was joining the military. After about 8 years, I decided it was time to pursue my passion, which was writing. I was very lucky, and I found a few members who are a part of Veterans in Film and Television. They not only took the time to ensure that I had the professional development that I needed in order to make that transition from an engineer to a writer, but they provided me with a community.
I wrote and directed an independent horror film starring Frankie Muniz. It's myself and a fellow VFTer, Richard Hanley. I would not have come into contact with that level of production had it not been for the efforts of VFT and sharing that information to their members.
I don't think that I can overstate the impact, the positive impact that they've had on my life.
I'm grateful for what VFT's done for me since my 3 years out of the military.
Thank you to the Hollywood Foreign Press for your support.
Veterans and new filmmakers in Hollywood and help them take a step up.
Now the VFT is aiming to expand their programs to other cities, including New York and Atlanta. With the HFPA's support, they can do that. We proudly accept this grant on their behalf.
Woo! And speaking of heroes, our final presenter of the evening is still fighting for the Jedis. Please welcome Luke Skywalker, aka Mr. Mark Hamill.
All right. Woo!
Great. Tonight I'm here to accept the grant for the University of Southern California's School of Cinematic Arts. And though I'm not an alumnus, I actually attended Los Angeles City College. Shout out to LACC, and I'm very pleased to say they received their own HFPA grant. Now, if you'll indulge a proud pop, I'm gonna go off script and point out that my daughter, Chelsea Elizabeth, graduated magna cum laude from USC, and went on to get her master's in communications management, and is currently seeking employment. But I did work a couple of times with a director friend who has a very close connection to the institution, and that would be George Lucas. In fact, George joins a very prestigious group of industry professionals dating back to Douglas Fairbanks Jr., Irving Thalberg, and Alfred Hitchcock, who've all been associated with one of the premier film schools in the world. For those of you who might not be familiar with their diverse program, USC offers multiple undergraduate and graduate programs covering production, screenwriting, critical studies, animation, and digital arts. Now the HFPA has stepped up with a $2 million endowment that will assist international students who attend USC but don't have access to government loans or scholarships and allows them to expand their creativity and perspective representing inclusion, innovation, and change. The fund will also create the Hollywood Foreign Press Association International Screening Series, which will showcase each year at least 4 international documentary and independent films. These free screenings, which are open to the public at large, bring to the forefront many films from around the world which otherwise might not get the chance to be viewed. I'm honored to accept this generous grant on behalf of USC. Now, interestingly enough, I brought my lines because there's something that's come up on the teleprompter that is quite unexpected. I was meant to finish by saying, speaking of viewing, please watch this short video, which will highlight what I've just been talking about. All right? Here we go. Oh, there's no more videos. Well, obviously, I've been pranked. But all I can say is I'm so proud to be here tonight. Obviously, education is so important to the success of young people, and the Hollywood Foreign Press has been doing great work for 25 years now, so God bless them all. Thank you and good night.
Okay, so that's what we call efficiency. That was $2.8 million distributed to 55 deserving programs and causes in just under 2 hours. And on this very high note, oh, come on in, come on, come on. And on this very high note, we want to say thank you to the Hollywood Foreign Press Association. And once more, here is the president, Meher Tatna.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank you again, Chelsea. And a special thank you to the team that made tonight possible, Elizabeth Sereda, Scott Orlin, Paola Abu-Jaudi, and Karen Martin. We would also like to thank our partners, NBC, Dick Clark Productions, and Moëtte Chandon. Please tune in to our anniversary show, the 75th Annual Golden Globe Awards, on January 7th on NBC. And in the meantime, you can see what we are up to at goldenglobes.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Golden Globes. Thank you and good night.